keep getting the love from my state.
What do I do
to keep the money coming in?
What do I do?
Writing until I need another pen.
Gotta make the right decision, or it might just be my last.
People view everything different when you're touching on the back.
What you see is good intentions, it's for clout and hitters, man.
You can never be yourself, you carry, gotta wear a mask.
They be pulling at you, grabbing at you, pop up, trying to change you.
I built my own foundation and there ain't no rearranging.
Moving careful every day is exactly how I played it. Not looking for no.
Charles and I sat for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup as we get a peek some of the stars in today's game. Well, will they be stars? Will you be a star? We'll find out. Let's play. Set to go now on a beautiful sunny afternoon. And off we go from Cleveland. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. Oh, a good looking return setup here. He's past the 30. He will score. Touchdown, Cleveland.
Coming back to the 25 instead of the 20. When guys fielded that deep in the end zone, I think most coaches want them to take a knee.
Yeah, it's resulted in more kneel downs. Not right there.
Extra point by Blankenship is up and good.
And it's now a 7-0 game. So let's try this again. After the kick return TD, here's yet another kickoff.
This one fielded at the 5.
Now a crease here as he's past the 30. Up to midfield. Look at him go inside the 30. He will take this all the way. Touchdown, Miami. That's a great response. You give up the first score of the game, but you go right down yourselves and get the equalizer.
I just had a flashback there. I remember playing in a game like that in college where one of my teammates had said in the media that week, the opposite team would be lucky to cross our goal line. They crossed it in the first minute of the game. On our first offensive play, we scored to answer back. Something similar to what we just saw there.
Very similar to what we just saw. So I'll leave it at 7 now as they kick it away.
And this will be returned from deep in the end zone.
And only able to get this to the 19, so probably should have opted for the touchback. So here's a first and 10 now down inside the 20. Brady now to throw. This is caught by Evans. And they're going to get this beyond the 40 before he's taken down. And we see the emphasis early here. Get your star receiver involved, able to do it successfully.
Not a bad start to begin with, that's for sure. And to me, this play says our guy is better than your guy's. Because, you know, a player of his stature, he won't just be single covered all game long. It's going to involve multiple people. And right away, they told the other team, guess what? He's just better.
Back-to-back good plays have him on the move on first down. On play action, it's Brady. Flushed out right. And it's incomplete. Took a shot, couldn't connect.
Well, they've got man coverage on the outside, and my scouting report on these DBs tells me that they love to take matters in their own hands. They want man coverage, not zone. And there was good coverage there that forced the incompletion.
Oh, he tries to force it in, and it's intercepted.
Picked off at the 20. And now off to the races, down the right side. And he will bring it back. It's a pick six and a Dolphins touchdown. Short throw pick six right there. Those linebackers, they love when those short throws come and those eyes.
Hold up, check me out. I think the tables and turned. Forget the bridge we don't build. This time I let them all burn.
They tried to kill me out.
Well, now it's the word.
I bring in paper, paper, paper from the first to the first.
They count me out. Now count me in. Oh, I'm hot. Sizzling. They count me out.
and now we get a peek at some of the top players here for this Madden Ultimate Team matchup. Brandon Gaudin, Charles Davis ready to go in the booth. We hope you're ready to go at the controls. Let's play. Just about time to get the party started. And off we go in Madden Ultimate Team. And here comes a return from a few steps into the end zone. And not a good return here at all, as they'll be forced to start at the 12-yard line. From down at the 12, it's first and 10. Here's Sims. Oh, he's going to air it out right away. He rifles one that's intercepted. Picked off by Justin Layne. And they get the football. They'll set up shop at their own 49-yard line. They may have thrown the interception, obviously less than ideal, but I think they also sent a message that they're going to push the ball downfield in this one.
Yeah, not afraid to take their shots right away, huh? What was that, like a 9-9-9 route? 9 meaning go? Just went ahead and went for it. Didn't work out so well because it certainly appeared the defense was prepared. But I'm with you. Okay, so it didn't work this time. Doesn't mean we won't try it again later.
And all the way in for the touchdown. Kyle Pitts, 51 yards. And his guys have taken a first quarter lead. Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And that makes the score 7-0. Out is the kickoff unit as they run up and send this one away. They'll elect to bring it out here from the end zone. Yeah, he'll be out of bounds, just shy of the 30, right about the 29. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. Not the start that they were hoping for. The interception on the first play of the game, it leads to 6 points the other way. How do you rebound? And a big loss here as he's taken down. After the sack, oh, they're staring at a challenge, basically from the other side of town. It's second and a country mile. Now a toss left side into the hands of his tight end. A big gain there after going backwards, and that'll lead to a third down. Now some movement before the snap. And we'll hear from our referee for the first time this afternoon. After the false start, sets up a 3rd and 9. Now Sims. He's got the hook up to Odell Beckham. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds. So on the other side of the field now, it's 1st and 10 as they've got things rolling on this drive. He'll let it go deep for Beckham. And he fires one that's intercepted. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And it's a good return here as he'll get all the way up close to the 35. What a start defensively. Your offense goes out, gets the touchdown, and then you get the interception. Just perfect.
How about the discipline that they showed on defense? Because after the offense scored to go up 7-0, you would think they might be a little extra aggressive trying to get back at them. Instead, they read their keys well. When they took the shot downfield, they were more than prepared for that one.
And now a throw on first down there, but it's incomplete.
2nd and 10. Kyle Pitts, the intended receiver.
And it's 2nd down. Looking to throw. Mixon. They look for Pitts again. This time he's got it. And he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. Throwing on 1st down. Mixon dancing to his left. And got his man complete. And they'll have it in the red zone before he crosses over out of bounds.
Well, it's almost as if they didn't leave the field after their first drive. They picked right up where they left off. Another good throw there. And this offense humming here in the early going.
From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. Flush to his right. Give him a couple on the scramble. It's second down.
Yeah, he only gets a few yards on first and 10, but he's better off doing that than throwing an incompletion or even worse, an interception.
Looking to throw on second down. Mixon, touchdown! Kyle Pitts with his second touchdown in this opening quarter. And his guys find a way to stretch that lead. Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And it's now 14 to nothing. The kickoff unit is out on the field, and they will send this one away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. To this point, the results have not been good. Two possessions, two turnovers.
And that's obviously something that can't continue, but to go a little bit deeper on that one, I would think about some play calls now, not even necessarily to my best player, but to someone I can trust with the ball. I'll try and get things settled down a little bit.
And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. They go play action here on first down. And here's another interception, the third of this first quarter. Picked off by J.C. Horn. And they will finally get him as he's all the way down near the 40-yard line. So more problems here in this first quarter. Already two scores down, and here they give away the football.
And if I'm the head coach, I think it's time to start lighting a fire under some of these guys. Now, you have to do it within your personality. They can't perceive it as fake, but I'd go get after some guys because they don't look ready to play to me. They look flat, uninspired. It's time to get moving.
On first and 10, Mixon eluding the pressure right. And avoids the contact by sliding. 14-0 to score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. From the 32 now, here's first and 10. Back to throw. Mixon finding room to the 20. And finally taken down at the 15.
Good strong throw and catch right there. And so far in this game, the alleys have been open for them to get completions, and they're taking advantage of it. First down at the 15-yard line.
On first down, Mixon. Mixon hit, and all the ball is out. And the Giants have it. It's picked up. And his guys are going to get the football at the 28-yard line. He was under duress, surveying, trying to find somebody to get the ball out of his hands. In the meantime, the defense, they took it out of his hands.
And when the ball snapped, I know exactly what the defense is thinking. Get a sack, put him on the ground. But when you can also knock the ball free while doing so, oh, there's the bonus for you as a defender.
A short gain here, maybe a yard to the 29. To throw on second down, Sims forced out to his left. He'll let it go deep for Beckham, and his pass is intercepted for the fourth time today. Picked off by Justin Layne. Well, we heard all week that they were going to put the football in the air a lot. The problem is that is now four interceptions, Charles, that he has thrown in this first half. How do you treat a situation? What do you say to your quarterback right now?
Boy, that's an interesting question because a lot of it depends on the head coach and the people making the decisions. You have to know your quarterback and know if he's mentally tough enough to have a chance to turn it around. Or is he a guy that maybe you've seen enough and it's time to go to the backup?
He's got a man complete. Touchdown. Devontae Parker 87 yards. And his guys are going to add on to their lead. Extra point by Anderson, up and good. And it's now 21 to nothing. Kick this one away, and off it goes. And we'll see a return here from the end zone. And in hindsight, probably should have taken a knee as he only gets this out to the 16-yard line. The Giants offense at the line, ready to begin their next drive. And some dangerous territory. You're already down three scores. A three and out here, or an inability to put any points up. This one might be over by half.
Yeah, and what you also have to guard against is calling every play for a big shot downfield. You know, thinking you're going to get all these points back on one drive. You're not. And last time I looked, it's still the first half. I'm not saying you have ultimate patience here, but you also don't have to go ahead and force everything either.
Third down, Sims. He's going to look deep down the field. And now here's another interception. Picked off at the 47. And he's going to take this one back to the 37-yard line. The interception woes, they just continue to mount. He's thrown five picks. At this point, you got to be thinking, is it something between the ears?
I think a confidence hit does occur once you start getting those numbers up there a little bit. But as you and I both know, it's not always.
And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Jack Youngblood in there to take him down on what will take us to the two-minute warning. We remind you that coming up at halftime, Jonathan Coachman will be alongside. He'll have highlights and analysis from Orlando on this first half of action. Looking to throw on second down. Mixon. That's going to be caught by Pitts. And they're able to work this to the 25 before it's all said and done.
Let's just call it what it is. This has been a flat-out struggle for this defense all game long. They've really had a hard time slowing them down.
Looking there for Pitts, but intercepted. Picked off at the 22. And he will bring this across midfield to the 49-yard line. Before we came up to the booth, last thing he said as we were walking off the field, want to play mistake-free football. Well, that just went out the window there with a pick.
And do you remember what you said to me when we were walking up to the booth after he said that? You're like, oh, fatal last words. Every time we hear that, things tend to fall apart.
And a big loss here as he's taken down. Now this one from about two counties over after the sack. They come up on a second and very long. Looking for his big receiver, Marshall. And my goodness, another interception. Picked off at the 28. And his guy...